Hello, my name is Behan Veli, and today we will talk about our journey at SAP with Bosch and Bosch DNS metrics. I'm a member of the Bosch team at SAP, and we are mainly responsible to operate and provide Bosch as a service for the SAP Cloud Platform. We also contribute to the Bosch core projects, and we share our knowledge with the Cloud Foundry community and with the SAP colleagues. So the agenda for today, we will have a short overview of the Bosch components. This will help us to set up the context for the different metrics which we will talk about. And also afterwards we will look into the different kind of metrics which you can have for the Bosch. And at the end, we will talk about Bosch DNS and Bosch DNS metrics. So on the director VM, you have different components. The main one is the director. It's responsible to orchestrate everything and also to provide the HTTP endpoints to the outside world. The database is there to store the director state. CPI is used to communicate with the supported infrastructures, and the message pass is here for communication between the components. Health monitors is responsible to keep the director instances healthy, and the blob store is there to store releases and compiled artifacts. Also, on every provisioned VM by the director, there is an agent, and the agent can communicate with the director via the message pass. So today we will talk about metrics for the director VM itself, metrics for the director, and also metrics for the other components which we see on the diagram. Okay, let's look into the VM metrics. One source for VM metrics is the Bosch agent itself. The Bosch agent can collect metrics and forward them to the message bus with the message bus to the director, and from there you can forward them with the help of health monitor to your monitoring step. The metrics are about CPU, memory, and disk usage. For example, at SAP, we have the following dashboard based on the agent metrics. They are aggregated and really simple. So you have metrics about overall CPU usage, overall disk usage for the different disks of the director, and about memory usage. And we have the following setup to get the metrics. So we have two directors, the outer Bosch and inner Bosch. The inner Bosch is our main Bosch, and we are collecting the metrics for the inner Bosch VM with the outer Bosch. Also, this setup has an advantage. You have resurrection for the inner Bosch. But there are also many disadvantages with this setup. For example, the metrics which you have are a really simple one. In a situation with outage where you have high CPU usage on the director VM, based on the agent metrics, you can't answer the question which process is causing the high CPU usage. Additionally, the changes to the metrics are almost impossible because they require agent changes, and agent changes are high effort tasks and bring risk with them. This setup also does not provide any metrics for the outer Bosch. And when the outer Bosch is updated, you don't have any metrics for the inner Bosch. That's why we are moving to a different setup with Telegraph. We co-deploy Telegraph with our Bosch directors, and we use Telegraph to collect metrics for our Bosch directors. Also, Telegraph can forward the metrics to your monitoring stack. We collect at the moment metrics for CPU, memory, disk, and network. And with Telegraph, you have an active community which is continuously improving the metrics, and you have plenty of metrics from which you can choose. There are really a lot of metrics, and also fine-grained ones, and really good choice here to have Telegraph. Also, Another advantage of this setup is you have metrics for the outer Bosch. So this is one dashboard which we have based on Telegraph metrics. You can see how much more information you have here for the direct to VM. You can have metrics for the network, disk IO, really important metrics, useful metrics, disk sizes also. You can have also process-based CPU usage, which we don't have here on the dashboard, but newer versions of our dashboard has CPU usage per process. Okay, let's look into available directory metrics. With the Bosch version 217.10, Bosch introduced a metrics server. It's not enabled by default. You can enable it if you want. And if it's enabled, you will have metrics about redirection on and off. The total task in the directory queue, metrics about unresponsive agents, available dynamic IPs, and total number of IPs, dynamic IPs. This is the dashboard which we have based on directory metrics. For example, redirection is is one metric which is really useful. In the past, it wasn't an easy task to find out whether redirection is on and off. And now, when you have a metric about redirection, you can even implement an alert based on it. There are outages which require you to disable redirection, and most probably you will forget afterwards to enable redirection. And this will cause unnecessary outages on your landscapes. Another metric, the unresponsive agents, is also useful in situation when you have issues with your IaaS provider. For example, network issues. If you have increasing amount of unresponsive agents, yeah, most probably you have network issues. Increasing task in the Bosch task queue can indicate that you have an issue with your Bosch directory. We have also plans here to improve and or extend the metrics provided by the metrics server. We will introduce HTTP metrics for the directory endpoints, for example, for latency, traffic, errors, saturation. We also think that metrics for the CPI operations are also useful metrics because CPI is the touch point of the directory with the infrastructure. And if you have issues here with the with your infrastructure, you can detect issues based on CPI metrics quite early and avoid unnecessary outages. So you have ideas to introduce the listed metrics, but if you have ideas for more useful metrics around CPI or HTTP, I'm happy to talk with you. Okay, let's look into the metrics provided by the other components on the Bosch directory. Most of the components have support for metrics, and you can enable the metrics with the properties which are listed here on the slide. If you enable the metrics, they will be exposed locally, so you have to find a way to forward the metrics to your monitoring stack. All the metrics are available with the direct version 268. And unfortunately, there is no support in the current Bosch release for local DB metrics. Also, if you have a setup with external Blob Store and external DB, you have to check with your provider what kind of metrics are supported there. We don't have much experience with these metrics because we have to postpone our work here in favor of Bosch DNS metrics, but we have plans to invest here and consume the metrics. Okay, let's look into Bosch DNS. The session today is quite short, and I'm not going to explain how Bosch DNS works, but I want to make the point here how important it is to have Bosch DNS monitoring. If you have a deployment where Bosch DNS is enabled, for example, Cloud Foundry requires Bosch DNS, this means that Bosch DNS will be co-deployed on every VM of your deployment, and every DNS request will be handled by Bosch DNS. And if the request is an internal one, it will be answered by Bosch DNS. And if it's an external one, then Bosch DNS is forwarding the request to the IaaS DNS server. For example, imagine a situation where you have a customer complaining about DNS issues. You will have tough times to find out where the root causes for the issues are if you don't have monitoring for Bosch DNS. Also, our experience is that the IaaS providers don't have sophisticated monitoring of their DNS servers, and you have to have real proof that their DNS servers are the root cause for the issues before they invest here. That's why we decided to invest in Bosch DNS monitoring. And with version 1.21 of Bosch DNS, we integrated the Core DNS plugin into Bosch DNS. And based on the Core DNS plugin, we can provide metrics for Bosch DNS, for DNS request in Bosch DNS. This feature is not enabled by default. You have to enable it. And if you enable the feature, you can check on the linked page here, which metrics Core DNS metrics plugin provides. Additionally, we have plans to improve the metrics here and provide Core DNS cache plugin metrics. The Core DNS cache plugin is used by Bosch DNS for external requests. So when an external request is happening, it could be answered by the cache or by the IaaS DNS server if it's not present in the cache. And it's important to know how many requests are reaching the IaaS DNS servers, because all of them have API rate limits. And most probably you want to know whether you are facing the API limits or not, and the cache plugin metrics can help you here. Additionally, we want to introduce metrics for the internal and external request. This is Bosch DNS specific, and with Core DNS, you don't have real support for this request. And of course, we will update or add documentation around this feature, which is not available at the moment. So for example, this is a dashboard which is built based on Bosch DNS metrics. You can see how helpful information you can find here. For example, how many requests are happening toward Bosch DNS. We were surprised to see how many requests Bosch DNS is handling. We didn't have any idea. Also, how many requests are failing or how long they are taking. I really recommend you to look into this feature. Also, we are recommending you to have VM metrics, and this is something which will help you with issues around resource utilization by Bosch DNS. We have had issues in the past where Bosch DNS used too much CPU, and having those metrics can really help you here. So thank you for your time. If you can, you want to reach me, here is my Twitter handle, and I am happy to hear your questions.